what happened on the bus?
Nothing. You're wasting your time.
Well, you never know.
What can I tell you? We were having a great time. We were laughing and we had a bottle.
Soldier come from?
He needed the bottle.
Keep going.
He needed the bottle, so we gave it to him. Could we please have that bottle back here? This guy can't wait.
So he was wounded.
I guess he was.
I wonder why he repressed that.
You a lot better if you didn't stare at them. The bus. We had to stop the bus and pick up some refugees. About a half a mile later, we took on some wounded GIs.
I got room in the back?
Yeah, take him in the back. I'll be right back there. I got him.
We gotta get this bus into the bushes. There's an enemy patrol coming down the road. Let's kill those lights. Nobody make a sound until they've passed us.
And then?
Well, we sat and waited, and the evening passed, and then this happened, and that happened, and this and that, and so and so and so and so and so and so and so.
Uh-huh.
They don't bother me till we start squawking like chickens. Not that I have anything against chickens personally. They're a much maligned bird in my book. I mean, take the common fallacy that chickens are afraid. Who else has the nerve to run around after you cut their heads off? Have you ever seen a chicken break out in a cold sweat? Have you ever known a chicken to have a weak handshake? I mean, I'll grant you, they're afraid of flying. In a recent survey, 2 out of 3 chickens preferred to take the bus. What about their contributions to society? I mean, just think of the great chickens of history. It's hard to think of any, isn't it?
Chickens take the bus.
As a matter of fact, there was a chicken on the bus. And it was driving me crazy. Every time it made a noise, I was sure the Chinese would hear it and find us. Everybody's life was in danger because of that damn chicken.